Alright, where we at? Let's go back. Because George W. Bush Sr. has been running the government in the United States since 1979. Let's not forget that he was head of CIA, right? And that he was in, allegedly, on the Kennedy get down, right? Well, William Greer, who was a Secret Serviceman and a CIA agent, who was the real gunman who came clean on his deathbed. Because you got to keep in mind, these guys come clean a couple weeks or 4 or 5 days before they die, right? Because they get this sentimental feeling in their heart about all the wrongs and evil and twisted things they have done, right? So they come clean on their deathbed. William Robert Greer, who was the driver of Kennedy's limo, is the real shooter who came clean on his deathbed, right? Because these guys get this epiphany, right, on their deathbed. Just like the guy Bill Oxley, who came clean about an assassination of Bob Marley, right? And went into great detail on how he was able to sneak into the Blue Lodge mountain range where Bob Marley was practicing it after the first attempt on his life when they tried to shoot him, right? A bunch of gunmen busted in his house and tried to shoot him. They couldn't get him then, so they sent Bill Oxley, who posed as a news anchor man, right, to get a report on the shooting, and snuck in, gave him a gift of Chuck Taylor's with a needle in the shoe, right? And the reason why they said they killed Bob Marley is because he promoted peace, and that went against their agenda. Now get a load of that, right? But these CIA agents, these FBI agents that do all this evil and all these hits, right? Allegedly for the government, we gotta say allegedly, right? For YouTube purposes. Do all these hits for the government, and then they come clean. They call them whistleblowers. And they come clean about the UFO technology and different things that they got that the government been having. And they come clean about these hits, right? Like James Forrester, who came clean on his deathbed about the reality of a group called Majestic 12 who handle extraterrestrial business. He mysteriously jumps out of his 16-story window to his death. In 1979 is when the Quiet War began on the masses of the people. A war not fought with bombs, not fought with guns, not fought with explosions, fought with silent weapons, which the woman talk about in the tape, right, called Must See Silent War. Check that tape out. Everybody feared George W. Bush Sr. It was something freaky about this dude. Well, nobody crossed the line with this cat. And George Bush Sr. is in bed with the Clintons. And I ain't even gotta beat it over your head to tell you what the Clintons is all about. They come straight out of Arkansas pushing dope, right? And a lot of people, they get in bed with the Clintons, right, get put out of business. Because Barry Seal was involved with that situation. And he was one of the ones of the many beings who got in bed with the Clintons who got put out of business. He's in bed with the Obamas. The Bushes and the Obamas go way back. Judge Joe Brown told you that. That Obama's real name is Barry Sorrento, and he's one of the 10 richest men in the world. And they're tied in with BP, which is involved with the oil spill. The Bushes been dealing with Obama's father, the Sorrentos, back when Obama was a kid. They've been watching, and they already knew that they was gonna make Obama one of their presidents because Obama worked for the Bushes. And there's a lot of strange things going on and dealing around this Obama cat. As in Barack L, one of the 200 fallen angels. The fallen angel that possessed his shell when he changed his name to Barack, right? See, these elites do a ritual to invite these demons into their shell. Overstand the entangle. And keep in mind, the 200 fallen landed in Or of Chaldea, who were fire worshippers who later migrated to Bali, Indonesia, and set it up their similar city as it is on their planet, right? And Obama is connected with Indonesia. It's all gonna tie back in together. Just hold what you got. The rabbit hole is deeper than you wanna know. And why does his name go so close with an abomination, which is one of the things that the Most High hate. He legalized homosexuality. He all of a sudden pop up out of nowhere, emerged, because the birth certificate, they found out that it was a fraud. Because the truth of the matter is that he was born in Chicago, not Hawaii. And that Obama, the African, is not his real dad. And you can clearly see that this African dude, who they calling Obama, looks nothing like Obama. And in fact, he was an agent as well, right? So this shit is deep. But if you look closely at this picture of Obama beside Malcolm, we can clearly see who he looked more like. He actually looked pretty close to his grandfather as well. But we can clearly see the connection here. This brother grew up about two blocks from where Malcolm X was at. This brother and his mama, who they said her name was Anna Duham, right? Which is not actually her real name, because she was working for the CIA. Her whole family was CIA. Her grandfather and her, she was a CIA agent used for a specific purpose. And they assigned her to Malcolm. We're about to tie all this in together for you and show you America hiding in the bushes. This brother and his mom was on the front page of a Savior's Day newspaper by the Nation of Islam. And I tried my best to find that picture, but they took it down off the web, because that would have been a key point to connect Obama to Malcolm X. And you know that Malcolm X liked the white girl, right? Supposedly before he came in contact with the Honorable Elijah Muhammad's teachings. And you gotta keep in mind that these people were working to infiltrate the nation to see what's going down. And that Anna Duham, whose real name is Anna Newman, who is the sister of Dr. Fred Newman, the philanthropist and agent who was used as Barack Obama's handler, that was helping black people get on the ballot, people like Jesse Jackson, right, and Al Sharpton, and you already know who they connected with, right? You already know who those brothers are tied in with, right? He was the same one that helped Leona Fulani get on the ballot. So he's the type of a guy that's an anti-Zionist type of a guy who been pushing for a black president for quite some time, but he's an agent, right? And Dr. Phil Valentine pointed that out. Meanwhile, Malcolm was meeting with international leaders, such as Fidel Castro. Well, several attempts was made on his life by the agency till he got tired of trying to kill him and he joined on with them. The Rockefellers wanted Cuba because of the export and import of sugar and tobacco. And they also wanted the territory to keep Russia out. And keep in mind that Malcolm X was meeting with Fidel Castro, and then all of a sudden, several attempts was made on him. He said, allegedly, by the agency. Overstand the connection between Malcolm and the Rockefellers and the Bushes. It all ties in together. Malcolm was also meeting with King Faisal, right? Who was a leader and president and king, right, and prime minister of Saudi Arabia. Look, who was later assassinated by I wonder who. And you already know what they did to Malcolm. So as you can clearly see, the Rockefellers is connected with what went down with Malcolm X. They're so sick, they would take his son and raise him as one of their own, to be a politician and leader, to lead the people for their agenda. If you go back, the girl on that tape talking about the incarceration of Baba said that Kedar Massenburg, the being who funded Jacob York down in a trip in Florida to plot against Baba, shook hands with George W. Bush in his mama's living room. And George W. Bush and them is in charge of the prison that Baba's at. So it's clearly seen that there's a connection between the Rockefellers and those who came after Baba. And get a load of this, there's Al Sharpton with Baba. And remember, we told you who he was connected with. And Saudi Arabia is one of the leading producers in oil. And who controls the oil business? That's right, the Rockefeller. If I'm standing on the corner where you live at selling drugs, and you normally sell drugs there, then you're gonna be wanting to get at me, right? Or it's called cutting out the competition. That's what it's about. Or getting them to join on with you in this case. After the king is assassinated, all of a sudden now, the Bushes, bagged by the Rockefellers, are in bed with Saudi Arabia. And if you go back to that tape, The Order of the Rose Part 1, Kathleen O'Brien told you that the Bush, that George W. Bush Sr. is in control of King Farhad of Saudi Arabia. George W. Bush Sr. also had control over Ronald Reagan, who gave the Satanic Church their chapel in 1966. And he's also in control of the president of Mexico, Carlos Slim. So now the Rockefellers have their fingers in on Mexico, as well as they connected with Pablo Escobar by the Clintons and Bobby Seale. So then the Rockefellers control the drugs as well. The Clintons is controlled by George W. Bush Sr. So they're in Colombia on the import and export of drugs. Malcolm X was also in touch with the president of Indonesia, Sukarno, right? And became good friends with him. And so you can see the connection and why they were assigned Anna Neumann, going under the code name as an agent, Anna Duham, to Indonesia. You need to go get a book called Pawns in the Game by William Guy. And you get a better grip on what's going down here. This is a chess game, and we're being used like pawns. And keep in mind, the Clintons and the Obamas is on Epstein's flight log, and Hillary Clinton is on Anthony Weiner's laptop, which is a thing they was hoping that we forget about. And we about to connect all these niggas for you. It's gonna make a whole lot of sense when we get to the finish line. There was an old lady who lived across the street from Obama in Chicago when he was a kid. She used to bake him cookies, giving him candy. A news anchor reporter got in touch with that old lady and was getting ready to go interview her. And right when he arrived to her house, the ambulance was rolling out saying that she was deceased. So understand the game and the significance of how tight and close-knit these people keep this game running. You see what I'm saying? And the old lady told those news reporters on the phone that his name is not Obama. His name is Barry Malik Shabazz, right? And if you keep in mind, they tried to play like Obama was dealing around with the church when he first got in, but he really was connected with Minister Louis Farrakhan, because the Minister Louis Farrakhan, I believe, know that he's Malcolm X's son. Check it out. And it's all gonna connect. And so they put Anna Duham on the brother from Indonesia so they can get a hold of that money. And they are a hold of that money, how? By Obama. So it's all for the connect for you. Like connecting the dots, connect both. And I ain't even gotta convince you that when little George was president, that his daddy had control over him. So George W. Bush Sr. controlled the whole United States from the time he took over the CIA, pretty much a little bit before that, until the time he died. He controlled all your last presidents, from Clinton all the way up until Obama. He even got some deals in the Donald Trump situation. And that's what things are gonna get freaky later on down the line. But we must take you back to show you the connection, because the Bushes are front man for a group of the Lords of London called the Rockefellers. And we gotta show you a connection that it goes all the way back. Let's connect these niggas. If the Bushes are front man, then who are puppeting these guys? We gotta go all the way back to George W. Bush Sr.'s grandfather, Samuel P. Bush, who was born on October 4th, 1863 in Orange, New Jersey, who was the father of Prescott Bush, which is George W. Bush Jr.'s grandfather, right? And the connection is in Ohio, right? The connection is in Ohio because in 1901, Samuel P. Bush returned to Columbus, Ohio to be general manager of Buckeye Steel Casting Company, which manufactured railroad parts, meaning the rails, because the trains need rails to travel on. Keep that in mind. And this company was ran by who? Frank Rockefeller. And Frank Rockefeller is the brother of the all mogul John D. Rockefeller, who's all reptilian Adam Baron hybrids, right? We about to connect these niggas, right? Because they control the oil and the steel. And this is the catalyst that put the Bushes in bed with the Rockefellers. Because they control the steel, they control the tracks, because you can't drive no train without the tracks. And keep that in mind. Keep in mind the two families we're dealing with at the top, the Rothschilds and the Rockefeller, right? And the Rockefeller is in control of the United States, while the Rothschilds control the other parts, right? And who are the Rothschilds and the Rockefellers? They are humanoid reptilians, hybrids, front man as well, so they drag on reptilian overlords. The Bushes are front man controlled by a lesser reptilian called the Villa, right? Which get behind, right, the eye follicle. And if you take a close look at Prescott Bush's eye, you can clearly see the reptilian Villa controlling, right, his right, your left eye. The reptilian Villa controlling his right eye. If you look closely at the picture, right? Prescott Bush was the father of George Bush, right, Senior, who we told you was connected, right? And keep in mind, through his grandfather, Samuel P. Bush, he's connected with the Rockefeller, those who rock the fella, right? Now keep in mind, the Rockefellers control the oil and the railroad systems because they produce the steel that the trains ride on. You see? So this shit goes all the way back. Keep in mind that Prescott Bush was born May 15, 1895 in Columbus, Ohio. We finna connect these niggas for you. The connection is in Columbus, Ohio, right? Where all the money is being funneled industrial-wise. Prescott Bush, which is the grandfather of George W. Bush Jr., right? Started the trends, the family trends of his family going to Yale, right? And graduating from Yale, right? And Yale is where the fraternity of the Skull and Bones is located. And you already know what the Skull and Bones is all about. And remember, I told you that the Skull and Bones were businessmen, politics, front man for the Lords of London. And Samuel P. Bush passed the torch down to his son, Prescott Bush, who later became a senator in Connecticut. And that's a whole lot of connections going on in Connecticut for those who see the T's. And Prescott Bush, the American banker who inherited his fortune from his father, who was the president of Buckeye Stealing Company, owned by Frank Rockefeller and his brother, John D. Rockefeller. And it was all in the plan because Prescott Bush got in bed with Eisenhower, who made deals with the Greys to be able to abduct people in exchange for technology. And Eisenhower was working extremely close with the Greys. You know, as in Eisenhower Boulevard in Macon, Georgia. But Prescott Bush was able to Fernando his way in bed with Eisenhower. And in 1956, they created the Interstate Act. And we as morals feel like you playing on our intelligence when you tell us about an act that's not a law. This is how the Bushes, by way of the Rockefellers, get in bed on the interstates of the United States of America. So now they're in control of the trainways and the highways and they're in bed as front man for the Rockefellers. Because if you control a country's transportation, you pretty much in control of the economy. Because these trucks, trains, and diesels are how most of the commodity is moved around here in the United States. And Papa Prescott passed the torch down to George. And this is where the saga begins. And now we're into some serious business, because this is where we left off in the beginning when we told you that George W. Bush controls the government and politics by way of the Rockefellers. And everybody held their mouth when they tried to mention George W. Bush Sr. because this guy was dangerous.
And if you take a close look at his right eye, you can clearly see that the villa is in control. The reptilian nature is in control of these beings.
Right? He had a lot of power, a lot of control, a lot of information from being up top so long. And keep in mind, Bush's whole game is a new world order. Not the law of the jungle, not no barbaric type civilization, is what he say, right? But we have chance for ourselves now to forge a new world order. And those who know can hear that fool, you know, when you plan a plan, the Most High can plan it better. The Bushes love going to war. Why? Because when you go to war, they're gonna call steel and oil, which is their two main commodities owned by their front man. You gotta build tanks, you gotta use fuel to drive those tanks. This is why the Bushes and Obama was in with the oil, man. The BP oil spill, right? Harlan Burden. The Bushes, they drill for oil, man. And what you're witnessing when they're invading Iraq, right, is like two gangbangers of blood and a crip fighting for territory or fighting for product. And while they're over there doing that, there's another group, right, that's looking for certain artifacts. And this is what's going down. Now we fast forward to George W. Bush Sr. passing away. And at his funeral, he wrote a type of will, F-U-U screw type letter to all the elites, and he passed it out, right? Now, if you look at when Hillary Clinton received the letter, she has this look on her face. And we who are experts at micro expression. And the look that Hillary Clinton has on her face when she views the letter, and the look that she have on her face is that she's disgusted. Joe Biden gets the letter and he's outraged. He's disgusted, right? Michelle Obama gets the letter, opens it up, and has a look on her face, the same similar look as Hillary Clinton. Joe Biden's wife sees the letter in a folder but didn't read it. Later, as they're rolling Big Daddy Bush coffin out of the building, a Secret Service agent hands George W. Bush Jr. the letter. It's obviously the look on his face that he knows already what it is, because you got to keep in mind he was hanging out with his daddy most of the time before he died and wheeling them around, right? So the look on his face is he already knew what was in the letter. His wife looks at it, right, and the micro expression that she gives is surprised with fear. And Jeb Bush takes a look at the letter and drops his hand off his heart, and he's angry. Right? He's angry. He's in shock. What was in them letters that made these people react the way that they did? I'll tell you.
The letters had a chain of up and coming Illuminati event, all planned as a bucket list for Big Daddy George. And on his bucket list, up and coming Illuminati events, and at the end it said that Mike Pence was the insurance policy. Now it's got to make me wonder what's going on if Joe Biden won the president election. And keep in mind that these guys are all in bed together. No doubt. One bird, same wing. So keep in mind what is going down here. This election is rigged. The guy they picked is already bought and paid for. Right? And I told you that Obama was with the Bushes, and if Joe Biden was his right-hand man,
you do the math.
They all in it together. You see?
So they have sold the railroad tracks and interstates by way of the UN to China. And on part two, we're gonna get in on the Rockefellers and the T-Bone connection, where they got you labeled, right, as black, Negro, and color in the state of Delaware and selling you as property, right? Because it's all connected.
America hiding in the bushes, being puppeted by the Rockefeller.